set his hands on me. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, he has a shine. I need you to get it down in your loins. Say, he has his hands on me. And can I get a little help? And if he has his hands on me, it doesn't matter the trauma that I'm going through right now. It got to be ordained. The nightmare that I just came through, it has to be ordained. I juggle all the time, church should have killed me, but I survived. I thought I went through something in the world. But glory to God, when you get saved, if you're not in the right church, then sometimes God will put you in a church that will take you to school like the world could have never taught you. And look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, when is your season? You don't come out mad as hell, but you come out celebrating that God has processed you and God has chosen you for such a time as this. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, your appetite is getting ready to change. So my neighbor, say, my appetite is getting ready to change. Glory to God, I can't eat drunk no more. Come on, should I? I need the meat of the word of God. I don't need thou laying down the truth. I don't need that, but I need the meat of the word. God's hands was on you until you went through something stupid. Got no help. Oh, I got a good marriage until you go through something stupid. It's not real until it's been tried. The Bible says the trying of your faith is more precious than gold, though it be well tried with fire.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, amen.
The Bible says, every man works on the trial.
Come on now.
But whatever salt it is, come on somebody. Yeah. I'm anointed, but you ain't ready to go through that.
Come on now.
Because he might want to anoint me again and take me through something else. And when he take me through, you're going to look at me and you're going to think I'm not saved. No, I got no help. You're going to think I'm out of the will of God because I'm going the way he want me to go and not the way you want me to go. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor. All of a sudden, we look at folk and say God is with them when they ain't going through nothing. But the minute they turn around and go through something, we say that's not God. But I thought he had his hand. Oh, you cannot teach, cannot teach you. Glory to God. Come on, somebody, give God a praise. How many know God will take you and he'll give you help in your marriage and bring you out and give you a marriage ministry? He'll put you through hell with your finances and bring you out and let you be a financial analyst. Lord, ain't got no help up in there. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. He'll save you from being a whore, from being a left, a homosexual, and then he'll put you over a ministry that will pull everybody else out. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor, but you can't be ashamed when they pull you out. Somebody give God a praise. Back our neighbor, they would say, yeah, I know I walk through the valley in the shadow of death. I don't feel no evil for that while. And not scared to comfort me. I'm going through hell, but he got his hands on me. Somebody's grieving up in here. Look at you and say, he got you, baby. He got you. He got you. God trusts you with what's on your life to set you before the priest and want you for your next. They ain't got no help here. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, can God handle you? Or can God trust you with a post-dated anointing? Lord have mercy, can he trust you with a post-dated anointing? He'll anoint you now for later. Lord, ain't got no help, ain't got no help. Come on, come on. Can you still be on the praise team, knowing that you're an apostle? Can you still be over the choir, knowing that you're a prophet? Can God post-anoint you? Lord, ain't got no help. God post-dated, glory to God, David. And David went right back into the field. Come on, somebody. He wasn't all struck up, but glory to God, he stayed there until his time came, until the glory came. Somebody give God a praise. The joy coming in the morning. Somebody give God a praise. I want to show you today that no matter how much hell you go through, God still has his hand on your life. Come on, somebody give God a praise. Job began to go through Glory to God. And his wife looked at him because of the hell he was going through. And she said, glory to God, why don't you curse God and die? Because I'm going through. That don't mean that God's hand is not all my life. Come on, somebody. The Bible said all his three friends, they mocked him. They were trying to make him think he had done something wrong because he was going through. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, going through don't mean that you've done anything wrong. It's just part of the process. Somebody give God a praise. Come on. And whatever you do, you can't afford the process. How in the world you gonna be an apostle? How in the world you gonna be a prophet? And you trying to afford the process. You trying to build out. Somebody give God a praise. Say, I'm gonna stay right here. And I'm gonna wait till my change comes. So I declare, oh, at my point in time, will I wait till my change comes? Now tell your neighbor, say, he got his hand on me. Every man, me, I want you to help me preach. I look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I want you to take the craziest thing that you ever went through and say, even in that, he had his hand on me. I was about to get a divorce. I was about to throw in the towel. Some of y'all did get a divorce. But glory to God, who you was with, what part of your destiny, Lord, ain't got no help. Some of y'all in here, married people, out of the flesh, y'all don't want to hear me say it. So God had to reposition you and put the right person in your life that would not compete with what God was saying for you. I still ain't got no help up in here. Somebody scream and say, he still got his hand on me. I want to bring me to the place that he prophesied over my life that I'll come to. Look at your neighbor. Say, I'm tired of being tough and ain't got no promises. I'm tired of being tough and ain't got no manifestation. I've been holding on for all these years. What a man, what a woman is. I want to fulfill what he spoke over my life. I don't want to get fulfilled. Don't get me wrong now. I want to finish. Right now, yeah. Just not designed to keep me. Okay. The design is not just to, but to bring me into the place of promise. See, many of y'all are losing your strength on retarded people. You'll go to jail for fighting somebody retarded. You got to look at folk and know that they ain't got no sense. You got to look through your spiritual mind and spiritual eye. Know they get a check every first and third of the month. Got no help in here. You got to look at folks and say, I'm not going to get involved in that. You got to be like Joshua. And you got to be like Caleb. Glory to God. When they got to their promised land, and they began this, God kept them. And when they God kept them in the wilderness, when they got to their promised land, everybody else needed help to harvest their crop. But Joshua and Caleb said, I'm still as strong as I was when I started out. But they were trying to tell him, I saved my strength for my harvest. I saved my strength for my promised land. You gotta start giving people a piece of your mind and tell them folk off. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, save your strength for your harvest. Save your strength for your promised land.